Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sirajul Afaisi. I welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to talk about polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbons, commonly known as PAHs. So, outline of my talk is objective, introductions, sources, uses and properties of PAHs, polyatomic hydrocarbons, environmental effects, environmental fate processes, degradations of PAHs, and conclusions. So the aim of this presentation is to previous contemporary information on PAH pollutions, PAH degradation, the fate and risk associated with the presence of these compounds in the environment, and also to enlighten on some well-known possible remediations. So, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, P4 polycyclic, A4 aromatic, H4 hydrocarbons, are widely distributed and relocated in the environment as a result of the incomplete combustion of organic matter. Many PAHs and their epoxides are highly toxic, mutagenic, and carcinogenic, and microorganisms as well as to high system including human. Although various physicochemical methods have been used to remove this compound from our environment, and they have many limitations. So what are PAHs? Polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons are hydrocarbons, organic compounds containing only carbon and hydrogen, and that are composed of multiple aromatic rings. Organic rings in which the electrons are delocalized. They are a class of carcinogenic organic molecules that consist of three or more benzene rings and are commonly produced by fossil fuel combustions. PAHs are organic molecules that form from a variety of natural and anthropogenic creations. Natural polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbons form from forest fires and volcanic eruptions. Man contributes PAHs by burning wood and incomplete combustion of fossil fuel. Compounds are numerous in fossil fuels such as coal and petroleum. Anthropogenic sources can be divided into two categories: the combustions of materials for energy supply, example coal, oil, gas, wood, and combustions for waste minimizations. So friends, you can see in this picture, sources and use. Although the emphasis is on avoiding exposure to PAHs, some of these molecules are useful for making medicines, plastics, dyes, and pesticides. You see even naphthalene, anthracene, and second fluorethene, a lot of compounds here. So some molecular models you can see here. So properties of PAHs, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons are lipophilic, nonpolar molecules, lipophilic. They tend to persist in the environment because PAHs are not very soluble in water. They are weakly volatile and dissolve weakly in water. All PAHs are solid at room temperature and have high melting and boiling point. The movement of PAHs in the environment depends on the properties such as how easily they dissolve in water and how easily they evaporate in the air. So this is the properties. PAHs greater than 3 rings and less than 3 rings. So you can see the water solubility, volatility, soaring affinity, condensation temperature, ecotoxicity, carcinogenicity, and examples. You can see naphthalene 2 rings, acetaphthene 3 rings, fluorine 3 rings, anthracene 3 rings, pyrene 4 rings, glycine 4 rings, benzoepyrene 5 rings, and benzodiazepyrene 6 rings. So environmental effect, mammals can absorb fast by various routes, inhalation, dermal contact and ingestions. Plant can absorb fast from soil through their roots and translocate them to other plant parts. Fasts are moderately persistent in the environment and can bioaccumulate. So, partition of fasts in natural environments, element of environment and percentage of total, you can see soil, fresh water sediments, water, air, vegetations, biota. So, how do pollutants get into the environment? You can see. So, fasts are usually released into the air or they evaporate into the air when they are released to the soil or water. Since fasts are generally insoluble in water and they are generally found adsorbed on particles and precipitated in the bottom of the lakes and the rivers or solubilized in any oily matters which may contaminate water. Fasts have moderate to high acute toxicity to aquatic life and birds. So friends, degradation of fasts in the environment occurs through the biological chemicals and photochemical process. These processes may also be utilized for remedial purpose. However, the degradations may result in a variety of transformations products, some of which could potentially accumulate. So, conclusions of this lecture is fasts are released to the environment through natural and synthetic sources with emissions largely to the atmosphere. Synthetic sources provide a much greater release volume than natural sources. Fasts are transported from surface water by volatilizations in soil and sediments, microbials, metabolism, is the major process for the degradation of fasts, and fasts have a potential effect on the environment both directly and indirectly. So these are the references. Friends, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel and thanks for watching.